Frederica Carolyn Washington, also known as Freddie, was born December 23, 1903 in Savannah, Georgia. She had five siblings and was the oldest out of all of them. Her mother passed away when she was 11 years old. She took responsibilities of her brothers and sisters while attending St. Elizabeth Covenant School until her father remarried. At age 16, Freddie discovered her interest for acting. She decided to move to New York with her grandmother and aunt. She studied at Christoph School of Languages and the Erge School of Dramatic Writing. In the early 1920s, Freddie was a dancer. She danced as a chorus girl in various black chorus lines and then became a specialty dancer in nightclubs and Broadway shows. Freddie won fame in the best black production that hit Broadway. It was called Shuffle Along. Freddie danced as a solo and with a male partner as well. Also, she danced alongside Josephine Baker. Freddie toured many places with her beauty and dancing talents, such as the Gallman Place, Casino Nice, Green Park Hotel, and many more. Her first film was Black and Tan, where she danced with Duke Ellington's band. Early 1930, she became a full-time actress. She starred in many significant films such as Emperor Jones, Mills Blue Rhythm Band, and 1 Mile from Heaven. Producers thought she was best at passing roles. Freddie offered black girls who passed for white type of roles. Freddie's best stage role was Mama's Daughters with Ethel Waters. In 1934, she appeared in Imitations of Life, where she played as a white woman known as Piola. This film made a huge turn in her career. She helped form the Negro Actors Guide with her friends Noble Sissel and Bill Robinson to help black performers in need and help fight discrimination and win equality for blacks. Also, The People's Voice was formed along with her brother-in-law Adam Clayton Powell Jr. Freddie wrote about her life, career, and terrible crimes of racism and discrimination against blacks in and out of show business. Freddie's first husband was Lawrence Brown, one of Duke Ellington's trombonists. They divorced in 1951 and she married Hugh Anthony Bell the following year. Bell died in 1970. In 1975, Freddie was inducted into Black Filmmakers Hall of Fame. In 1979, she received the Soroka Award for Lifetime Achievement in Performing Arts. We found interest in this because it showed the complications ivory-skinned African Americans faced during the Harlem Renaissance period. Freddie Washington died June 28, 1994, at age 90, in Stamford, Connecticut. She left a legacy by showing she had the ability to transform the constraints imposed on her art into a life of purposeful activism.